Hello world. Today is July 20th, 2011. I don't have a printer at home. In fact, I only got online at home in 2007. And my spouse doesn't have a desk job. And I don't like to treat him like my errand boy, and he sure doesn't like it either. So I'm going to try to forward this article from Yahoo France to him in the hopes that he can eventually print it out so that I can refer to it later, but it just occurred to me that might not be possible, so I'm going to make a clip of it. This is an article about the most polluting foods in the world. And it says, no, it's in French, I'll try to do this quickly. Beef as a meat emits two times more, I mean, as the animal and everything, carbon dioxide than a pig, four times more than a chicken, and 13 times more than vegetable proteins such as beans. It is, but lamb is the most polluting food on the planet. Okay, it says, we know that meat is bad for the environment, contributing to deforestation. For example, the ruminants reject important quantities of gas, greenhouse gas, in the atmosphere during digestion. For example, the famous cow burps. It's not cow farts, by the way, it's cow burps. Rot de vache, it's called here in France. All right, but nonetheless, even though we know this, the worldwide consumption of meat has skyrocketed in the last four decades. Okay, that's my mosey off-site backup. Production of meat has tripled between 1971 and 2010. Oops, I don't need to zoom on that. And the experts estimate that it will double again by 2050, more than 544 billion kilos per year. The Environmental Working Group has calculated the impact of meat consumption and other foods, integrating into our daily life. Worldwide emissions of carbon dioxide, excuse me, I think I said carbon before, I meant carbon dioxide. They have to judge the quantity of carbon dioxide emitted at each step of their life, I guess of the food, of food production until it ends up in the wastebasket, in the garbage. According to their calculations, lamb has surpassed beef in polluting qualities. Even though the two animals have similar characteristics, they're both, they have ruminant stomachs, which, and they eat pretty much the same thing. The lamb emits 50% more CO2 gas per kilogram eaten uniquely because it produces less edible meat than the cow. So I guess they're trying to compare apples to apples. It says to produce, eat, and throw away less meat would permit a notable reduction in carbon gases, carbon dioxide gases and stuff. The cheese produced from cow milk, which generates a lot of carbon gas in its production, I think it means even more than beef meat, takes first place. The authors of this article underline that the consumption of cheeses, which are less dense, is already a bit more eco-friendly, in that they require less milk. Now, then they compare pork and industrially raised salmon. By the way, any salmon that you see, which is like orange or pink, that's industrial. It's been farmed somehow. Wild salmon is gray. Okay, so it's polluting. We know this, you know, fish farming and stuff, because it requires food brought by man, which is fished or cultivated, or worse, transformed, for example, into animal farine, you know, like animal feed. EWG has in effect taken into account the food needs of all of these animals and calculated that into the pollution factor in their production, and also the pesticides and stuff found in them, and fertilizers, without speaking of water generally used in astronomical quantities. Contrarily to viande précité, I don't remember what that is, the vegetables emit themselves more carbon dioxide after their production, despite the possible utilization of chemical products that might be used during their transformation, I guess the harvest, their transportation, cooking, or at the end of their lives. It seems, on the other hand, otherwise, that a considerable part of this pollution could easily be avoided by about a fifth of the emissions coming from the trash, which are useless. That's to say, digestible, you know, compostable stuff, and not the other stuff like bones and cooking fat, which I don't believe you can compost unless you do something to them. As far as, you know, farmed salmon, the people who raise them and the consumers are both responsible for a loss of 44% of the production. I don't know what that means. Okay. There is urgency to open a better management of our food, you know, a better way of dealing with it. To eat, to throw out, and to produce less meat could thus permit a substantial reduction in carbon output, if you want to call it that, carbon dioxide gases, greenhouse gases, whatever. If the entire American population turned vegetarian, it would result in the reduction of 4.5% of national carbon dioxide emissions, being the equivalent of 46 million cars less on the roads. Whatever the tastes are of each person, the fact is that the abuse of meat, now that's the word they use, is not... eating a lot of meat is not only bad for our planet, it's not very good for our health. Okay, now what was the source for this article? Sorry, but you know, I'm doing other things and I'm getting ready to go to bed and I shouldn't even be in front of a computer screen in the evening because it messes up my sleep cycle. Let's see what the source is. It's by somebody named Jessica Rat. R-A-T, rat, it's pronounced in French. Yeah, it does mean rat in French. And this is from my Yahoo page. See, here are people commenting. And it says thegreenweb.com. So I guess that's where this was published. All right. I must say that... we've really changed what we eat and how we eat in the last few years here in this household. And we don't have meat every day. We have very small quantities of it. No more poultry. Definitely nothing factory farmed as far as poultry goes. my spouse forced me to watch a documentary about battery chickens and stuff. And there is an industrial turkey farm near our country place, and it stinks, and we never see the birds, and I'm sure they're suffering. And my cholesterol, since I gave up poultry, went to a normal level for the first time since 1988, and it's just a lot easier for me to feel better and lose weight. So this is too long. I'm sorry, but I did the best I could to share with you. Hopefully I won't have to post this because I can get a printout of it and do something a little more concise. But there you go. Okay, be well, people. Bye.